Hello everyone and welcome to episode 17 of My Candy Love High School Life. A shattered mess. If nobody is able to see the real Deborah, there is still time to get back at her Discover Rosalia's plan and do everything in your power to make sure it works. Ever having cried because of Casio, Quentin consoled me. Then Rosalie came to tell me a plan to stop Deborah and Quentin left us alone. We should go someplace more secluded, right? We couldn't talk in the hallway after all. Where do you want to go? Someone could catch us anywhere. Yeah, we should talk outside of school. Outside of school? We could go to my place. Oh yeah, I've never been. I'm curious to see your room. Let's do that then. We will meet at my place. Wait. We will have to tell Lisander before we go, so he can come too. Lisander? In my room? Is that a problem? Well, not at all. It will just be the first time in my life that a boy comes into my room. Alright, let's do that then. We can meet in front of the school. Once Lisander knows, then we can go to your place. Okay, let's go find Lisander. Oh no, it's Casio. I really don't want to talk to him. Barely, about what I said before. I ignored him, turned, and walked away. For someone who never wanted to talk to me again, he changed his mind pretty quickly. Jerk. So, you had a nice little talk with Casio from what I've heard. This seems funny to you, I guess. I will have to admit that your little quarrel made me laugh just a bit. It would have given anything to be there. Did he tell you about it? Yes, he was a bit resistant to share, but spit out the story in the end. Yes, something was bothering him. Bothering him? Maybe he felt stupid afterwards. Yeah, I mean, not too much though. Don't go thinking and fighting with you affected him over or anything. Here again. Oh, actually, did you change your clothes? No, I took a shower in the locker room. Oh, that's why it still smells like toilet water when you talk. I won't even take the time to answer that. You're not worth it. Too bad for the hour of detention, but I'm glad she thinks I'm responsible for the buckle of water that fell on her. There was a fight in the hallways. Do you know anything about it? Even if I did, I wouldn't tell you. Chill out. I didn't attack you. Sorry, it's because I was the one to fight with Casio. Here's Armin. I just saw Quentin. He told me what happened with the board. He said you weren't doing too well. He didn't have to say anything about that. He didn't do it to be mean. I'm sure he seemed a bit bothered. Bothered, I wonder why. Maybe because he took me in his arms. You believe his then about the board, I mean? Yeah, I wasn't too smart before. I should have insisted. Listen to what you had to say before assuming anything. Well, I didn't hate you or anything, so I guess it is not a big deal, right? I did think that you would trust me, so I was a bit disappointed. I will find a way to make you forgive me. Oh yeah, why is that? I don't know yet. Give me the time to find some ideas. I'm still happy you finally opened your eyes. Good then. What are you going to do now? Well, Rosalia has a plan. We are going to meet at my place to talk about it. Do you want to come? Go to your place to talk about an attack plan? Of course, I mean, this will be fun. Of course, if you want, with Lisander, that will make two boys in my room. Good thing my mom isn't the suspicious type. Should I go now, or do I have the time to talk to Alexei beforehand? I still haven't told him what happened with the bar, and seeing as he seemed to be on her side, I should really let him know. You can go tell him. I still haven't told Lisander. Here, take my address in case. I gave him my street and number. Okay, see you later. I will hurry. Quentin is here. Are you feeling better? Yes, thank you very much for having consoled me. It was nothing. I'm sorry for having. I mean, I hope I wasn't too abrupt. Too abrupt? You were comforting me. Don't worry. Why are you smiling? I'm just happy. I was just thinking that you are smiling again because of me, and that's a nice fault. Thanks, Quentin. Don't blush. Don't blush. Both of you had a plan to guess the bar. We are going to talk about it at my place. Do you want to come? Why not? You never know. I may be useful. Great. I will give you my address again in case. I gave you my street name and the number on a piece of paper. What time should I come? There isn't really a time. I haven't told everyone yet. Ah, okay. At first, I will just wait in front of your place. Okay. Nathaniel's here. Billy, listen. I'm sorry. About what? You know what I'm talking about. Oh, you mean sorry for having acted like a big loser and abandoned you just to maintain my pride? No, I don't forgive you. You are really not cool this time. If I say that I was a jerk and apologize, will you change your mind? You have to make an announcement for that, or publish it in the school paper. I don't think that Becky will be interested in an article like that. I would really like to read something like that, then I won't be the only one who gets to blame for something in that paper. Please believe me, I'm really sorry for everything. I was a bit too proud and I regret it. You really acted like a coward. If you have other names like that, don't hesitate. You were pretty selfish too. But most of all, a jerk. You already said that one. Don't smile like that. I'm being mean to you. I will have you know. I deserved it. Will you forgive me? A selfish, cowardly jerk still has hidden qualities, right? No, you should have thought of that before. I don't want to see you anymore. Well, if you are going to act like that, have a nice day. I guess I bought him, but whatever. He should have supported me instead of turning his head. But I guess I won't be running into Nathaniel very much for a while. Ah, here you are. So you look like you are feeling better. Some more people believe me, so of course this makes me feel better. I'm happy for you. Rosalie has an idea to guess the bar. We are going to my place to talk about it. Do you want to come too? Of course. It will be my pleasure. I have the feeling that everyone thinks that I'm having a party at my house or something. Are you coming? I told everyone to meet at my place. They are going to be waiting for us. I had something to do before. Come, can I meet you later? Oh yeah, if you want, here's my address. Thanks. And there are going to be quite a few people at my place as you get moving. Everyone has my address so they can all get there without me. Everyone left. I don't like staying in school too long after classes are over. But nothing can happen to you. But yes, do you remember when we talked for the first time? You discovered a ghost in the school, and the mystery still hasn't been solved. Sure, it was Lisander. Lisander is a ghost? No. You didn't know Violet? Why do you think he dresses like that? It's because he's from another time. Shoot, how long has he been here? That's not nice to make fun of me like that. He's just joking. Of course Lisander isn't a ghost. If you try to talk to me like before, it'd be better off if I leave right away. Okay, did it then change LM with Violet, maybe? No, still nil, on zero. Okay. Sorry, I just had to check if it did change something. Well, I will have to leave the school now. Leave the school. Rosalie is here. I find you. Lisander isn't with you? No, he had something to do before he could come. I see. Let's go then. Wait, other students are meeting us. Really? Spies? No, I don't think so. I don't see armor in the role of a spy, except for in his games. Yeah, me neither. Are we meeting them here then? No, I gave them the address. They can meet us there discreetly. Directly. We can go. Okay, off we go. How do we get to your place? We can go to the city and the park, or take the bus. It will drop us right next to my place, but we have to pay for a ticket. It's kind of expensive. We should walk to the city. Don't you think? Maybe we'll run into some boys. Is it like? Seeing as Rosalie wants to go to your place on foot, the bus stop isn't available for the moment. You will be notified when it becomes available. So, because you're now going to your room, you can put something on your dresser to unlock maybe a dialogue, but also to get your LM with some of the boys higher. So you go to your apartment and then to your dresser. You can place this on your dresser to make an impression with Genting, and I already did that in one of my other videos, so I'm not going to do that this time. Normally, Nathaniel also comes to your room, and you can place this on your dresser to get something positive with him, but since he is not coming this time, it's no use. And but Lisander is coming. So, and with putting this picture of Lisander on your dresser, you may unlock something with him. So we are gonna try that. Yes, it is on my dresser. See if it works. Armin, you are here. I was getting ready to go to your place. Is something wrong? You seem angry. I just talked to my brother, and the creep didn't want to listen. He told me the most idiotic things I've ever heard him say this after his impossible states. He really didn't believe you, but you are his brother. He's really annoyed me this time. Just wait until tonight. We are going to have a little conversation, him and I. No way. If he shares my plan with the bar, we will be in a bad shape. Who do you think you take Alexei for? He would help his greatest enemy, but even if he doesn't believe me, he would never share the things I tell him. Still, be careful what you tell. No, but he hasn't been himself lately. It's not normal that he believes the bar. Least to Bora and not his friends or brother. Yeah, I don't know what is up with him. Tonight I won't let him go before he tells me what is going on. I hope that he won't stay angry with me much longer. I miss him. Well, seeing as I ran into you, I will finish the walk with you. With you too. Okay, at least we are sure that Armin will be there. Here, we could pass through the park. There's a little exit that goes straight to my place. It can only be opened from the inside. We could also pass in front of the stores. It's the same in the end. Stores or park, you live in a great area. Yeah, I'm pretty lucky. You know, if people are coming over, don't you think it would be nice to have some snacks? You think? Are your explanation going to be that long? Exceeding mine less than well. I have an idea, but not a plan of attack. Okay, I will buy some chips and something to drink then. I can come with you. You always go buy what you need alone. You can go to the donut shop on the city map as usual, or you can go by foot. If you choose to go by foot, you may meet a character and unlock a dialogue with them, and raise your LM with them if it is a boy. To show you this time, you must go by foot, because Rosalie and Armin are with you. Then you can choose the other times. Is this your apartment? Yes, but we should go to the door shop first, because no one is waiting for us here yet. We have the time. Okay. I will wait for you guys out here. If I go in there I just be frustrated. Why is that? I don't have any more pocket money, and there are new games out this week. I won't be able to buy anything. It will just make me mad. Okay, I won't insist. Rosalie and I went into the store. Are you going to buy everything here too? Yes, you can always find anything you need here. Yeah, it's great for that. I'm going to look and see if my perfume is here. I'll be right back. Okay. Oh, I didn't expect to see you here. Nina, you are far from home. What are you doing here? I saw Lisander around. He was in the school supplies aisle. Ah, so that was what he had to do before coming over. Are you still following him? Whenever I can. He's too adorable. Well, you might not see him tonight. He's coming to my place. Your place? Oops, maybe I shouldn't have said anything. I've gotta go. I'm in a hurry. I hope she didn't take that badly. Help! I went to buy some chips and candy. There were also some packages of cookies, so I grabbed one before heading to the checkout counter. That will be $7, please. Pay. Rosalia, I've got everything I need. Are you coming? Coming? I didn't have enough money for the perfume, so I will come back another time. We left the store to join Armin. continues here. If you were looking for his honor, wasn't it so that he would come too? I don't see him. He had something to do before coming here. He shouldn't be too much longer. I opened the door. Come on in. I had everyone gone up to my room. It seemed much smaller to me all of a sudden. Your room is so cute. Thanks. You have a portable game, too. It's not the same brand as mine, but at least you can you play. I get the feeling that he is relieved. And to think I would have done just about anything not long ago for you to invite me here. Oh man, what a mess. What is this closet? Don't open my closet without asking for permission. You should take better care of your clothes and these underwear. You will never get a guy wearing these. Rosalia, oh my gosh, please tell me that she didn't say just that. I must be hallucinating, right? She said that. She talked about my underwear in front of the boys. I'm mortified. That sounds just like Alexei when he takes care of my closet. Funny. Then, no, it's not at all the same. I don't think Alexei talks about your boxers in public. Do you want us to leave you alone? I don't feel like I belong here all of a sudden. No, I closed my closet and forced Rosa to stop the inspection. We are going to have to do some shopping together. Why me? Lisander isn't here yet. I hope that nothing happened to him. And no, that was not just a desperate attempt to try and change the subject. Maybe he got lost. I don't think so. It's really easy to get where I live. Don't forget we are talking about Lisander here. Well, okay, yeah, he probably got lost. I'm going to get him. Don't ruin everything in my room while I'm gone. Don't worry, we will keep Rosalie from organizing your underwear. But how did he just talk about my underwear like that? I got a little carried away with the blatant absence of lace in your laundry. Maybe I should have contained myself. Yes, please do contain yourself. I ran down in a hurry, and when I arrived at the sidewalk, I ran into someone. Ugh, I know I'm small, but still, you could have paid attention. Nina, did you follow me or what? So what? I can follow who I want. Is it because Lisander is coming to my place? Is he already here? No, he must have gotten lost. Or he just didn't want to come. I'm sure that's why he's not here. How can she go from one emotion to another so quickly? But you know we aren't going to be alone. Rosalie and other friends are with us. Really? Of course, my parents wouldn't let me be alone with a boy in my room. Can I come too then? Well, we are going to talk about something that happened at school, and since you don't go to her school, I don't think you will be interested. Something is happening at your school? It's complicated. Since you don't want to tell me, I will just go ask Lisander. I will find him first, and he will tell me everything, and I will give him a hug to thank him. Don't touch him. Hee hee. She left running. Shoot, I need to hurry. I traced my pet peppers, but I didn't find any trace of Lisander. Maybe he's still in the school. I was Lisander and I was lost. Where would I hide? Oh, what's that? I picked up a piece of paper that was at my feet. It's one of the papers I wrote my address on. That explains everything. He lost the paper. I'm sorry, I got lost. I noticed I've been looking for you for a while. I found him before Nina. I walk around the neighborhood before I remember that the best way to be found was where you lost is to stop moving and wait. Did this save us some time? Yes. Sorry, I couldn't find the paper you gave me with your address on it. That's normal, you dropped it. I found it earlier. You seem to find everything I lose. It must be a sign.
A sign?
Yeah, yes, a sign that we complete each other. You lose things and I find them. I like your way of seeing things. It seems to have got his attention. In any case, I know what to get you for your birthday. What? A GPS? You could do a joint gift with my brother then. You want to get me one too? We will see. Are you coming? The others are waiting for us. Here we are. Lisander! Huh? That voice. It's Nina. Lisander, you're here. I've been looking for you everywhere. She wrapped her arms around him. Take Lisander by the arm and move him away. Nina, please, we are in the middle of the street. Let him go right away. I took Lisander by the arm. Can't you see you are bothering him? Nina was forced to let go. You're bothering him too. Look at him. He's all red. Huh? That is enough. We need to hurry. I think we need to go now. We'll come back later, Nina. Okay, see you later. That's right. Get out of here. This means war. Whoa, there. Finally, where were you? He wandered on the other side of town. No, he was close by. No, he was close by, but seeing as we were looking for each other, we missed each other several times. I'm sorry, I'm late. I lost the address on the way here. It's bad for you. You missed the inspection of the underwear of I stopped Armin's foot before I had time to say anything else. Where did you get this picture? What picture? He showed me the picture of him on my dresser. It was during one of my concerts. I didn't know you were there. Oh man, I forget to put that away. She wasn't there. It was me that took the picture. Don't you remember? I told you about it. That's it. Rosalie distracted him with something else. I don't remember that. I'm just surprised to see it on your dresser. Dresser is all. And it's such a pretty thing. It's because Violet went out of her way to make it. I wasn't going to leave it in the closet. Don't bless. I would do the same if I had a picture of you. Oh, you are so sweet. Gasp. I wasn't expecting that reaction. Did I say something wrong? No, no, not at all. He's blushing. Oh. I really like the dialogue that it just unlocked. Alright, now that everyone is here, let's get down to business. Do you guys want snacks? A snack? I have chips, drinks, candy, cookies. I meant serious business. Cookies, awesome. I like some, please. I gave him a pack and everyone served themselves with the rest. So where should we start, Melody? Why don't you tell everyone what happened up until now so we all be on the same page. Okay, I told everyone everything again. The arrival of Deborah, my ruins confirmed the threats. The Wale de Fel, Deborah, Kessel turning the other way. Just made a little detour around the park where Kessel made me cry. And didn't want everyone to know. Thanks, does anyone need any other information? Times like these made me wish I could great chop her to pieces like in my games. Well, then maybe a bit too much, Armin. Calm down, Armin. We should never lose our cool. Look at me. I hate her, but she has no idea. And I would never get mad in front of her. She could use my anger to her advantage, and that's the last thing we want to do her. Melanie has already proved that to us. Right, but great isn't such a bad idea. Anything to bring her down is fine by me. The editors are scaring me. Continue, please, Rosa. The only calm person here is him. Yes, so I looked for a way to make her pay for everything else she has done, without resorting to anything childish, vulgar, or violent. She turned towards Armin and continued. If you had let me settle things with her, things would have gone a lot faster. Get it out with that already. It's not the idea is not to go to prison. She isn't delicate, but she is subtle, so I had to find something up to her level. She completely ignored Katyn. To make her want to leave everything here, we have to present her with something way better, like a manager with more influence who is capable of launching her to stardom. Wait, I thought that the aim was to punish her, not to help her. Don't interrupt me. I'm talking about what we need to make her believe. The manager, we are going to propose a leak. I heard someone spit out their juice behind me. Leak? But he doesn't look like her manager. Plus, he is to meet. He doesn't talk much. He doesn't have the right energy to be a... He just can't do it. I agree with Lisander. Stop it, alright. He needs a little makeover. But after that, it will be a piece of cake. I'm not sure. Sorry, but who is Leek? Oh yeah, he's never met him. It's Rosalie's boyfriend, and he's on his older brother. He owns the clothes shop. Okay, and has Deborah ever seen him? I don't know. I wouldn't have suggested it if I didn't already know. She's never seen him. Besides him, who could play that role? Okay, but Dave, but I think he already, but I think he is already back in Australia. Let's do it then. We can try to make Lee the perfect manager. That's the plan. We can meet up tomorrow then. Not all of us. We'll make small groups. Groups, why? We'll be faster, that's all. We need a group to find the closer leak and another to find some information about the manager. Did you say that Lisanne's brother owns a clothes shop? Why can't he take care of that on his own? He needs to start getting into character tonight. He won't have the time to find a suit. Something is telling me that the night is going to be long for him. So, Benedict, what do you want to do tomorrow? Look up information about managers at school. Okay, who else wants to go to school tomorrow? Me, I don't like going out. I could have bet on that. I see the story enough as it is. I will go do some research at school tomorrow. We will be three then, great. And you, Rosalie, what are you going to do? I'm going to see Lick and tell him what he has to do tonight. Then we will start training him to be the perfect manager. Pompous and superficial, just like the bar likes them. Wait, you still haven't told him? See you tomorrow and good luck. And another thing, don't forget to be discreet during the next few days. Everyone went home. The next day after class, I wait for the boys in the hallway. Here you are. Sorry, I took a little walk while waiting for you. It's okay. What should we do now? Where should we look for information about the you know what? There's a library at the media room, right? Yeah, but I don't know if they will let us do research that isn't school related on the computers. We could say it's for a future job search or something, a career plan. Let's go near the staircase already. That's where the library and the media room are. We can figure something out afterwards. Oh, this is the first time I've seen the three of you. She looked at Armin, then Lisander, then me. We have some things to do. Homework, all three of us have problems in math. Oh, really? Can I come too? I didn't understand everything in class earlier. Well, actually, it's most for me. I didn't get anything the teacher was talking about before. They actually don't know what they are getting themselves into by accepting to help me. They won't be much help to you. Nice one, Armin. Okay, good luck then. I'm sure you will succeed, Armin. She left. I don't like to have to lie. We didn't really have the choice. It wasn't really a lie. I really need help in math. I didn't understand a thing. Really? It wasn't that hard, though. Probably, I don't know. I didn't listen to the teacher. His voice is so hypnotizing. I was wondering how the rest of the class managed to stay awake. Say, shouldn't we stay a bit separate? If I let someone else, the borough could see us too. No, going to the same place at different times is weird. That means we don't want to attract attention. Going together means that we don't have anything to hide. Do you see what I'm getting at? Yes, I think. So let's go. What are you doing here? We wanted to go to the library. You aren't allowed to go upstairs after class until after you have had your detention. But why? Because you threw water on the student. Now go back downstairs. Okay, shoot. I didn't think this whole story would block me this much. Can we go? If you are spending time with a girl like her, it's because you aren't any better. Go downstairs, all three of you, and go home. Armin muttered something. I didn't understand it, but looking at his face, it wasn't very positive. Now seriously, who does she think she is? A girl like her? And she knows you? And is it even illegal for her to not let us use the school material? Outside of class time, yeah, I think so. So we will have to wait at some point. We can go wait in the courtyard before trying to go back. I think this is our best option. Even a 5 minute power outage doesn't get me this irritated. She's really done it this time. Armin, we are just downstairs. She might hear you. We advance each of us on our own. Get closer to Lysander. I hope that the principal will go home soon. Me too. I will never thought that she wouldn't let me go upstairs because of this whole ordeal. She doesn't want any madam in her establishment. Her reaction is normal. So you mean to say that I'm a bad seed? I didn't really appreciate it either, I'll have to admit. Hope one day she will realize that she made a mistake. Besides convincing Amber to admit that it was her, I don't see how. Just tell yourself that you didn't do anything. That's the most important thing. You are a good person. Thanks, Lysander. What should we do? Shouldn't we go see if the principal is still around? It's nice out. Let's stay outside. I think that Armin doesn't really like to be outside. You think? Haven't I said it enough for you to be sure? You don't like getting a little fresh air? It's not the fresh air that bothers me. It's the light. There's too much of it. It hurts my eyes. That's because you have blue eyes. I don't know about that. In any case, I don't like to be outside. Why didn't you say something before? I suggested that everyone meet in the courtyard to wait. I was too into the whole thing to think about it at that moment. Oh, look, the principal has left the building without seeing us. Huh, let's go then. Yeah, of course. Well, the library area or the media area? Are you serious? We could waste our time in books when we can just Google the media. When we can just Google the media room, is it then? Obviously, you have got to keep up with this time. You can't find anything on the internet now. We went on the library and sat in front of a computer. We found lots of information and we were able to print out several pages to give to Rosalia. We found everything about the Boros Group and being a manager. We even found the school where Lee could have studied. I hope this will do it. This should be all right, don't worry. I will give it all to Rosa tonight. I can imagine that she will come by the house again. Okay, wish her good luck for me. She got some work to do. Just copy paste all those lines has made me tired. I can't even imagine reading them. Don't you read the guides for your game? It's not the same. Those are interesting. I'm not going to stick around. If you guys don't mind, see you tomorrow. See you tomorrow, Lysander. I'm going home to see you. I'm going home. See you later, Armin. I'm not going to hang around either. See you tomorrow. Yes, see you. Oh no, wait, Armin, you didn't tell me what you told your brother last night. He didn't hear me. Oh well, I will ask him tomorrow. I left the school. Time to go home now. Now you can take the bus to correct to directly go do to go directly home. Just click on it, careful. This move costs 5 action points and not 2 action points. I still don't quite understand why it says that, because we don't pay action points anymore by move, but with dialogue. Weird. And I played this game twice yesterday, and I read it twice yesterday, and it didn't come to me until now. That's also weird. If the bus helps you get home faster, it can also make you miss bonus dialogue that may allow you to raise your LM with a boy. It's up to you to choose how you will get home. Hey, Melanie. I turned around to see who was talking to me. It was Armin. Talk to him. For a moment, I thought you were going to just walk by without looking at me. Of course not. I'm excited to get home, but not that excited. I won't bother you long then. It's just that I don't go to see you very often outside of school. I wanted to take advantage of the moment. This is nice. See you later. See you later. Phew, what a day. I wonder if it would be better if I change my outfit for the next few days. The plan is coming together, and like Rosalie said, we need to be discreet. I left to go to the clothes shop. That's better. Here we are. With this, it will be perfect. I blend in with the scenery. I went to bed early. I was excited for the next day to see Rosalie and find out how our project is coming along. Once back at school, I started looking for her right away. What are you doing? I'm looking for Rosalie. Have you seen her? I saw her in the halls earlier. She shouldn't be too far then. I finished the book yesterday and now I don't know what to read. Could you suggest something to me? A police novel. Nothing is better. I think I've already read everything about it. Try qu criminal biographies, then. They are not bad either. I don't think that's my cup of tea, but I'm happy to see that you like police novels. So is everything going well? Are you going to attack soon? I don't know yet. I'm looking for Rosalia, actually. I haven't seen her, sorry. It's all right. How do you want to, here, do you want a copy of the newspaper today? Edition? Talk about all your achievements since the bar has come back. You know what you're doing is really mean, Peggy. If you didn't want to see it on paper for everyone to see, you should have behaved correctly. And I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about coming to show me your paper on purpose when you talk about it, about me in it. Yes, so I wasn't thinking about being mean. It just came out like that. And if you didn't want to hear people comments, you shouldn't have done anything. She laughed, a little irritated. I think that this time I managed to get at her a bit. He's writing something in his notebook. Look over his shoulder. I leaned over his shoulder and put one hand on him. What are you doing? I'm trying to read what you are writing. I wasn't writing anything. I was trying to draw. I can see that. There's a stick figure evolution draw in his notebook. Don't make fun of it. I did my best. What did you want to draw? What I had on my mind. What were you thinking about when you drew that? No one in particular. He is whistling while organizing his bag. I didn't get a chance to talk to you yesterday. That is rare. I thought you didn't want to. Yeah, well, I was angry. Is it just me or is everyone being nice with me today? Are you going to stop avoiding me already? I didn't do it on purpose today. I didn't see you before. Because that was the case before. Of course, you told me not to come near you anymore. This is what I'm doing. I didn't leave the time to respond and walked away again. What's wrong with you? I heard that you were punished for the water on the Bora. Yeah, are you thinking that's funny? Totally, you gave me a solid alibi. I told myself that the tension was the price to pay for soaking the bar with toilet powder. And in the end, you are the one that got the detention that I was expecting. I should that sort of thing more often. Yeah, sure, go for it. Next time, I won't be there to take the fall. I heard you. What? Shoot, she knows that we are planning something for Deborah. Amber and you, I heard you. Why didn't you say that you didn't do anything? It's not fair. Oh, that, because at the moment no one believes me, so it doesn't matter. But you have an hour of detention because of that. Yeah, that's the only thing that makes me angry. I'm sorry for you. Oh, Rosalie, do you have everything you need? Yes, now it's just a question of time. In the meantime, I'm begging you not to get yourself into a sick situation. Ashley knows this is her order. Don't do anything stupid until Nick is ready. Okay, alright, it's not my fault. It's almost everything I start to finish badly. Can we talk for a bit, please? Please, are you feeling all right? Yes and no. I think the answer is clear. In a snap of finger, I found myself pinned against the wall with Castiel's arms above my head. Listen to me already. I'm sorry. I got carried away. I should never have told you that. That's too easy. Easy. I will never forgive you. I'm not asking for forgiveness. I'm just asking for you to understand. But I understood. You hate me. You don't want to have to do anything with me. I got the message, loud and clear. Do I look like someone that hates you? You look like a jerk. That's enough. My comeback surprised him. He moved and I managed to get away. This is the chance of a lifetime. Someone I know made their own album and wants me to play with him as a professional. If you want the best for me, like he said, you should understand this opportunity won't come up again. And you are trying to ruin everything by pinching the bar to leave again, by lying. You have been acting out in the worst way possible recently, and it is against a person who didn't do anything to you. I think that is enough for a reason to make me mad. I didn't lie, and no, I don't understand why you are planning your hopes in a girl that has already made you suffer. She just placed her career before me. I would have done the same. No, I know you. You wouldn't let anyone down. I walked away, ignoring him. Before stopping, I turned around towards him and looked at him the most contemptuous look I could make. Oh, and actually, Rosalie was right. Those clothes don't suit you at all. You had a certain class before, and now there's nothing special about you. I left immediately after. Good for him. I hope I made him the most uncomfortable as possible. I felt a hand grab onto my arm and pull me into the classroom. At first I thought it was Cassian again, but shh, it was Alexei. But what are you doing? Armin came to see me 2 days ago. He must have told you, but because he came to see me in the middle of the hall, I had to continue lying to him. I had to wait until we were home alone to explain things to him. Lying? Explain what to him? I don't understand what you are saying. Quietly, I don't want anyone to hear us. I'm not mad at you, Benedict. I know that you didn't do anything wrong. I'm beginning to doubt the boy when she started crying. And then I knew for sure that she was faking when Violet and I took her away to calm down. She went a little overboard. You believe me? But of course, Violet has known her for longer, so she left herself be convinced more easily. Except crying like she did because someone she had known for less than a week didn't like her. Well, it was a bit too much. But you said you didn't want to talk to me. You seemed disappointed. I know, I'm sorry, but you saw me in the hallway and the bar wasn't very far away. I had to. And to what? You couldn't tell her right away that you didn't believe her instead? You let me think you were mad at me. She refused to talk to Nathaniel when Violet tried to assert her by saying that the student president could help her. And the day after, she didn't want to see Lisanna and Rosalia because we saw them talking to you in the halls. I thought that staying on her good side wouldn't be so bad. You were skeptical of her from the beginning. I ended up following your lead. But why didn't you tell me before? We never ran into each other after that. I mean, after our conversation in the hallway. I guess we didn't. I don't really remember. Well, I can tell you for sure. I didn't have the occasion to be alone with you until now. And even now, I had to pull you in here by force. The only time you were free was when you were looking for Amber, and you didn't see me. It was really frustrating. But, and Armin, why didn't you tell him before? You had the occasion with him. But I told him 2 days ago at home. Not because he didn't care about the whole thing. He doesn't really judge others. He hasn't said anything to me about it. He could have assured me. Well, he told me what happened with Cashel. He didn't really go into detail, but I can imagine that you felt horrible. So I wanted to talk to you myself, because if I left him talk to me, he could never have done it. It? Smile. He made a huge smile, then advanced towards me. See the illustration. He held me tight in his arms, holding back his laughter. Shh. I thought we weren't supposed to make any noise. Sorry, I wanted to do that for days. Oh, I almost escaped it then. Oh, did it bother you? A little, but oh well. Shoot, I'm sorry. All right, I'm leaving. If someone saw me come in here, I will be in trouble. Okay, I just wanted to know, did you learn anything about Deborah by talking to her? Nothing that you don't already know. According to Armin, if what she told me is the truth. And he left the room. Phew, Alexei isn't mad at me, and he never was actually. In some way, it's a great story because we have a spy and the boy doesn't suspect a thing. I tried to explain to the principal what happened, but she didn't want to hear it. It's all right. It's all right. It's nice of you to try. I'm really sorry. I would have really liked to help you. Oh, you are so sweet, Violet. Don't have to be sorry that you already tried is enough. You are certainly my favorite character. Maybe I should have spoken louder. I just saw Alexei leave the room. Were you with him? Yes, but don't say anything. No one should know. It's all right. Almost everyone left. Shoot, I forgot to tell you that he doesn't really believe the war. I'm such an idiot. I thought he told you not to say anything. Yeah, but he was mean to make me think that he was such a creep. I want to get back at him. Poor guy. He just wanted to help in his own way. Otherwise, Rosalie said to meet her at the city park. She thinks that the you-know-what is ready. Oh yeah, great. Let's go then. No, I will wait for you tomorrow in the halls to see how it goes then. Oh, goes with Deborah. But it's out of question that I go to the park. It's worse than the gardening club. Okay, see you tomorrow then. See you tomorrow. I left the school. Now it's off to the park. Melody, we are over here. I got closer to Rosalia. And my eyes were immediately dawned to Leek. Hello, Melody. I hope that you are well. Hi, Leek. Oh, man, you look classy. Thanks, I had a hard time getting used to it. Here comes the man in black. See, he's perfect. We just have to introduce him to Deborah tomorrow. But how will we do that? We will just go in to say he wants to see her because he has something to say to her. And he was in the neighborhood, so he's taking the chance. Don't you think that Deborah will be skeptical? One of her friends couldn't just introduce me to her and say that he offered to make me to her when I asked. If it is one of her friends, then she will necessarily think that we are trying to trick her. Oh, that's not a bad idea. I'm sure that Alexei will be thrilled. I thought he was mad at you. It's more complicated than that. I will explain later. Okay, let's meet up tomorrow to put the plan into action. Armin will be there too. And we will be hiding in the corner to make sure that things go well. Do you want to come with us? Of course. I wouldn't miss this for the world. See you tomorrow. Yeah, see you tomorrow. I went home all excited. My parents received a note from my detention, and I got in trouble. I'm not allowed to go out for a whole week. I know that everything will soon be over. Will soon be over made me quite happy. I had a hard time falling asleep with everything that's going on. The next day, I went back to school with butterflies in my stomach. Please, Alexei, join me in the classroom. Don't ask any questions, just come with me. What's up? Did something happen to you? No, nothing bad. We have to plan to catch Deborah, except we need you right away. Really? My brother is really dumb sometimes. He didn't say anything to me. Maybe he's still mad at you because you lied to him. I explained our plan to Alexei. Yeah, I would never have thought about doing something like that. Rosalie is genius. You can help us then? Yes, of course. As soon as I see Rosalie's boyfriend, I will bring him to Deborah. Great, we are counting on you. Now I need to join Alexei and Rosalia. The boy is talking with a stranger, and she asked me to leave them alone. Do you think that's normal? It was surely someone who is important. She could have at least told me who it was. Psst, Melody, come here. Armin and Rosalie were hiding behind the lockers. What are you doing? We are waiting for you. Lick and the boar are a little further down the hall. Wanna go see? Shoot, really? They are already there? I was wondering if it was really necessary that I come with you. Why? Well, two people hiding is more than great than three. Come with us anyway. Okay, I will come. I didn't have to ask her twice. Let's go, yes. I hope that everything will go well. The boar and Leek were both at the end of the hall. Leek was against the lockers in a very relaxed stance. The boar was in front of him, with her hands behind her back. And you came all this way just for me? If our voice sounds really unusual. No, not really. I was in the neighborhood, and seeing as I heard you were at the school now, I said to myself, hey, why not? Oh, in your face, Deborah. Look, I don't have the time to lose here. I am here to make you a proposition, and I want to know if you are in or not. Whoa, way to go, Nick. It's really into it. What do I mean by coming to you? The recording company that provide my manager is perfectly adapting for young artists, and my percentage on sales with him is much more reasonable. Oof, that would have been too good to be true. But does a big percentage matter when you are only seen locally? What I'm proposing here, listen to this, a contract that will take you further than this pop than town, a larger distribution network, a better manager advertising campaign, and a smaller presentation, of course, but the one that will bring you way more than your ridiculous current sales. Man, Leek is awesome. I would never have guessed. He was well prepared. That's my Leek. I've never seen her so proud. Ridiculous? If they are ridiculous, why are you interested in me? Shoot, he offended her. Because I've got flair, darling. And the creep who is organizing your life right now doesn't even realize what he has in his hands. I prefer to outdo him before it is too late. She's considering the pros and cons. I told you I don't have all day. If you are interested, tell me now. Wait, wait. Don't be in such a rush. This isn't a decision to be taken lightly. She got closer to him and put her hands on him in a very flirtatious manner. No one is saying anything else. What is going on? Nothing. She got a little closer to him. Closer, Minnie. Let me see. Stay where I am. Stay calm. You might ruin everything. I wasn't really worth it to come if I can't see anything. I'm sure the two of us could go very far, but I need some time to think about it, understand? You really don't want to leave me any time? A day or so? What's the difference? She put her hands on her waist. I don't want to wait for anyone, that's all. You don't want to do me an itty-bitty favor? I hate girls who violate that comment. I wouldn't be doing you a favor by leaving you the time to refuse. So you really think I'm worth it? She keeps on boasting. I've never seen her use her charms, but she actually is kind of good at it. I won't repeat myself, yes or no, and Leek stays calm. Let me call my manager to talk to him about it, all right? And just wait a little moment. You can give me that, right? Say yes, Leek. Say yes. Very well. You have 5 minutes. Is that enough? Thanks. I won't be long. A man's almost in the back. I can't believe it. If she goes into a classroom, three of us will be too many. Will you continue watching, Melody? Of course. In any case, I'm surprised, Rosa. I thought that you would attack her after seeing her flirt with your boyfriend. You weren't kidding when you were talking about self-control with Melody. She didn't see that. See what? Armin, I kept her from seeing that on purpose. See what? I'm going to go quickly follow Deborah before Vince gets out of hand. Oh, it's you. I don't know what you prepared for Deborah, but mostly his boyfriend isn't here by accident. He recognized him. Your plan works. Whatever the result, I would like you to go to the teacher's lounge. I've prepared something for you. The teacher's lounge, but it's always closed. No, not always, no. He was spinning the keys to the teacher's lounge around his finger. Carefully. This time Armin did it. They ended up behind the lockers. Don't worry, I know how to be careful. He said it too. Don't forget the teacher's lounge. It's okay, I wonder what he did. Hey, Stephen, I'm sorry to call you like this in the middle of the day, but it is pretty important. Yes? She's already on the phone. Well, someone else has spotted me, and you see, he treats me like I deserve. He thinks I got the real potential and that I can go far. Do you understand? It's working. It's working. So, you know, I love you a lot, and I don't want to leave you for someone else, but I need a little more consideration to go further with my career. If you could just reconsider the way you handle my career, you would be a doll. No, it's actually not working at all. And I will stay, of course. Yes. Bye. Wait. No, that's not what I mean. What? That's not, you don't know what you are losing. So my sales won't have picked up if you have done your job a little better. That's it. Right, fine. See you later, loser. See you up. Turn around and saw me. What are you doing here? I came in here by accident and I saw you. It's not going too well with this, Stephen. It's my manager, that idiot. He's been thinking about ending my contract for a couple of months now, because my sales are too low and my anti, I mean, stuff that you couldn't understand. You don't have a manager then? Wipe the smell off your face. I found it better. I haven't lost anything. Oh, okay. I don't think so. It worked. I'm going to leave before she realizes something is up. Now that's done, I wonder how we are doing to make a real. Now we are going to make her realize we tricked her. Hey, watch out! Don't stay in front of a door like that. I almost knocked you over. Shoot! I moved over to left her pass. You, Rosalia. What's wrong with you? How dare you put your hands on my boyfriend? I'm warning you. If you touch him again, I will make you regret the day you were born. Your boyfriend? But I've never met your boyfriend. I didn't even know you had one. Armin saw you do it. Don't lie. Why did he have to open his mouth? You are crazy, Rosalia. I would never. But what the? She took a step back after looking behind Rosalia. Rosa, please calm down. She didn't know. You know him? Oh, she's starting to understand. Of course I know him. He's my boyfriend. Your boyfriend is a manager? No, he owns a clothes shop. What? But you said that. I'm sorry to have lied to you, miss. But from what the people I love told me, you deserve a little lesson. A lesson? She immediately turned towards me. A lesson? Is that it? I think she's going to explode. What are you doing? The plan worked, but Deborah is running after me. Oh yeah, try to lead her to the teacher's house. Nathaniel has a little surprise for her. Oh yeah, that's right. The door to the teacher's lounge was open. No one was inside. At least we are alone, just the two of us. Deborah came in and closed the door behind her. Did you have fun making me lose my contract like that? Do you realize what you have done? I wasn't alone. Do you think you have won something? Even if my manager has left me, another one will come along soon enough. Her voice was trembling with rage. If the first one didn't want you anymore because of your sales, no one will. But now I have Cashew. The situation has changed. You don't have anyone yet. He hasn't decided yet. It's only a question of time. That idiot believes anything you tell him as long as you look him straight in the eye. He's the one out of all the idiots at the school. He will come with me. He will help boost my career with his talent and style. And when that is done, I just have to play the same scenario as last time. The same scenario? You will drop in again? Of course. Two is a crowd under the spotlight, so my dear, don't fight victory yet. I've got the whole school in my pocket. It's not you and your idiot friends that are going to bring me down. I've lost anything and will never lose. You didn't need to trap me to tell me that. Why did you follow me? Because you are a little too stubborn for my taste. Since the day I met you, you haven't stopped trying to trick me. And this time you almost did. If I did have a backup plan, you would have succeeded now. I want to be sure that you won't go against me ever again. Why is that? I've never had to turn to force, but too bad you have left me without a choice. Force? You want to hit me? Don't do it this time. If you hit me, no one will believe you. No, if I hurt myself too, I will just say that it was that I defended myself. After all, everyone believes that you are already trying to attack me. She got close to me. Stop! What's this? On the desk behind the chair, there was a little red light next to the microphone that the principal used to make our announcements to the school. This wasn't the thing you planned. He turned the loudspeaker in the teacher's lounge. Now tell me, it's not true. Tell me, it's not true. I ran off immediately. Deborah caught me by the arm. You little pest! You knew! Let me go! You are hurting me! How dare you! She raised her hand to hit me. But someone grabbed her arm to stop her. An idiot? Is that it? Cashel! You misunderstood, Cashel. It's not what you think. Not only it was Melody that said the same thing, but when she called my name, she had a real reason to. Wait, I was kidding. She wanted so much to make me look mean that I wanted to joke around as if it was real. That's enough now, Deborah. We heard everything. You really think that we are a school of idiots? No, Violet, you are certainly not an idiot, and the school certainly also not. But no, of course not. It was a joke. You know that I love you, Violet. You don't know. Why doesn't anyone believe me? After all that we have done together, you won't take my words because of a tiny little joke? I doubt the ability for a reason far less important than this one. Iris, she looks so sad. Cashel, believe me, please, kitten. I think that it is time you leave the bar, definitely. His voice was so icy that even I got the chills. I just wanted. I was kidding. She left crying, real tears this time. All the students were there. They didn't stop talking about Deborah and tried to make eye contact with Cashew. He looked at me sadly and then left. Iris, are you alright? You aren't too shocked? Oh yeah. At least no one will be taken advantage of by that girl. That's a good thing, right? Yeah, sorry, I forgot something in the basement. She left quickly in the opposite direction of the basement. Shoot, I thought that everything would go back to normal. I said that nothing is going to happen right away, but everyone knows that I didn't do anything wrong at all. Are you alright, Violet? What a scene, right? I'm not crying, you know it's alright. You didn't know she was mean. She ran away without a word. Man, even Violet is avoiding me. I don't understand anything anymore. What did I do now? It was fun. It wasn't as fun as the bucket of water on that girl's head. But I have to admit that the loudspeaker was quite genius. Thanks. Why did Emma just compliment me? Don't go crazy. I'm telling you that because my brother told me that it was the one who had the idea. It's great when he put his mind towards things. Like this, you know what I mean. I have to say the same. There's a good thing done, right? If you only knew how happy I am. I can imagine, did you get the apologize you deserved? No, actually, everyone is avoiding me, I think. I thought that Iris, Violet and the others would come see me, but when I saw them, they all ran away. Really? Maybe they need some time. They were close to the bar. Or it's a whole other problem. I've got to go. I have something to do. Okay, see you later. A mother got into him. He seems to want to talk to me, though. Are you still busy? Yeah, but we'll have time to talk later, don't worry. Why is he smiling like that? Oh, Kim, I'm going to change my approach this time. I won't talk about Deborah. Say, have you seen Cashel? I've been looking for him since earlier. No, I haven't seen him. Too bad. I have something to do, sorry. It's alright, she left. I felt just as bad as when I got to school today. But it should be just the opposite. But it's not true. Where did he go? He didn't go home, did he? I would have seen him leave the through the courtyard. I found him. Guess you'll wait. Can you leave me alone, please? I don't feel like talking. But you shouldn't be alone. On the contrary, that's exactly what I need. He continued walking away. Leave him alone for once. I can't imagine that he really needs to be alone this time. Seeing behind the borrowers really affected him, more than anyone else, I think. Oh no, I didn't see the time. My detention starts in 5 minutes. I don't see anyone else in the hallway. I must be the last person here now. I forgot my letter at home, and I have no idea which room to go to now. No luck. Here you are. I was sure I saw you in the hall. You weren't thinking of skipping your detention, right? No, not at all. I couldn't remember which room it was in. It's in classroom A. I will meet you there, all right? I'm supposed to watch you. Okay, at least I know. At least it's not the principal. Mr. Verace isn't here yet. I sat down at the desk to wait for him. Then someone opens the door. What are you doing? I've been punished, remember? I got detention because of a bucket of water that fell on the borough. And you are alone? Mr. Verace told me to wait. Told me you would meet me here. I see, we have to act quickly then. Act quickly, what do you mean? He turned towards the door and pointed towards the silhouette that was in the front of the entrance. Someone wanted to tell you something, but didn't really have the courage. My eyes widened with disbelief. I was everyone walked into the room. See the illustration. Hi. What are you still doing here at school? I thought that everyone went home. Lisandra came to get us. I didn't know what to say to you since the borough made her announcement. I will have to admit that I'm glad I had the idea to do this. To do what? That everyone came to see you at the same time. Came to see me? Why? Sorry. I'm sorry for not having listened to you. Is that what you are trying to tell me earlier? We all tried, except it's not easier to apologize when we were all wrong. Oh, girls, I'm really happy. You know her for a while, that Deborah. You never expected this of her. It's not the best excuse in the world, but it's the only one we have got. Don't worry. That's what Lisandra Mosley had told me. I will do whatever you want to make it up to you. Don't worry about it. You're not mad then, because of me? When I think about how I left you alone, while you are so nice, well, I got so angry with myself, plus you got detention for nothing. No, not at all. I even thought that you were still angry with me, and I was really sad until about 5 minutes ago. Really? Oh, Melody! She let go of drawing folder and took me in her arms. It was the first time that I saw Violet act first. We should go before Mr. Ferrace comes. See you tomorrow, Betty. Good luck for your detention. Thanks, see you later. Everyone said goodbye, then left. Mr. Ferrace came a few minutes later, and I had to do an extra homework assignment. But after the surprise visit from everyone, it wasn't that bad. Everything has finally fallen into place. Congratulations, you finished episode 17. Finish the episode. So this was episode 17 with the parts of Lisandra in it. Thank you all for watching. I hope to see you back in my next video. Maybe until then. Bye!